Good evening, everyone. I'd like to get started. We've got everyone up here.
I think we've got most of the stuff ready to go.
The first group you're going to hear tonight is the 7th grade band. And I thought, what a wonderful way to start off a concert with an upbeat polka. Not very often are these students ever going to play one, so I thought it'd be kind of fun to one out.
If you feel the need to get a polka, there's a little room up here or in the back.
Okay. All right. Thanks for coming out tonight. And our first selection is Pennsylvania polka.
Right. For our next piece, we're going to play Russian Sailor's Dance, and you probably remember this from the Mass Band concert. And the reason I do this for both groups is because it gives us an opportunity to go after those minor details that you don't always get to when you have certain amount of time with each concert coming. So it kind of gives us the time to drill in on some of those simple mistakes and fine-tune the piece. So. Without further ado, Russian Sailor's Dance. All right, as the percussion finishes settling in, I'm going to talk to you a little about Chant and Jubilee. This is kind of an interesting piece. I keep bringing it out every fall, and I set it on my desk, and I look at it throughout the year, and I wonder if I'll have a group that'll be able to play it. And this year, I pulled it out again, and I thought about it, and I said, yeah, I think the seventh grade group can do it. And what's interesting about it is that they're going to be asked to sing. I know. Brace yourselves. But they do a nice job. It's very difficult. I think it gives them a real appreciation for what their counterparts do in choir class. It's very revealing and difficult to kind of put yourself out there. But they do a nice job. And we also get to do some other stuff. The brass, trumpets, and trombones get to play with some mutes. And we've got some neat percussion stuff going on. So our last piece with the seventh grade portion is Chant and Jubilee.
Thank you.
What you have in front of you is a percussion ensemble at the Eminem's Holiday Concert. We put on more of a mallet-pitched percussion feature, and I tell them that if they're willing to put the time into that one, then I'd let them do a drum one in the spring. So what you got right in front of you is our middle school percussion ensemble, and we're going to play Picky Percussion. The next group we're going to have is in our middle school woodwind choir, and it's made up of our flutes and our clarinets and our oboe, and we have a couple bass clarinets in here for good measure. We're going to play a piece entitled Ein Klein Nachtmusik by Mozart. You will instantly recognize it. The title in English means a little night music. So here we go. Our next piece we have is going to be performed by the 8th grade group. It's entitled In the Hall of the Mountain King.
Thank you.
Right.
Our next piece is Pirates of the Caribbean. We played this at Mass Band a long time ago now, and I asked them if they had remembered doing it. And that's how I remember when we do stuff, is when kids go, yeah, we did that, then I kind of know how long ago we did it. And they don't remember it. And it was every year we do an eighth grade pick, where I let the eighth graders kind of pick something that they would like to play. And it came down to this one and Sweet Caroline. And so I said, well, this is a great piece. If you're willing to put in the extra effort, because it's a difficult piece, we'll do both. So here is Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
for some of you have had multiple children come through this program, you've noticed that every spring I break out the tuxedo. And I had to buy it in college to play in the ensemble I did. And I just feel it a shame that it sits in the closet from then till I don't know when I'd pull it out again. So it's kind of nice to pull it out every spring. And there is definitely one family that can attest that I have worn it every single spring. And the last of the Bertrand clan is now going through. I've had all four children, started with my first year here, sixth grader, and now we're ending with Greg Bertrand, our last one. And so for the Bertrands, no more long lines waiting for Mr. Tennell's conferences. No more eighth grade concerts where they decide to give me stuff that only makes me bigger and fatter, but I still love it. So I'd like to say thanks for doing a great job with your children and keeping them all involved. That's great. I'd like to take just a few moments and talk about this group. They've overcome some challenging things. Our first year here, there were so many of them that had started, we couldn't fit them all in one class. So we had to split them up a little bit. And so that made it kind of a challenge because they were used to certain players with them at Lincoln and Lindbergh and Knight, and now they were in a kind of a different jumbled situation. But as their seventh grade year progressed, and then this year, they've really come together. And I would definitely say that they are now a band. They have banded together and definitely lean on each other and support each other. And so that's pretty amazing that they've come that far. And they've worked hard and put some wonderful concerts together over the years. So, and then at this point, I'd like to kind of give the Dale Middlestad Award. And for those of you that have heard this speech many, many times, I apologize, but it's really difficult to select two members or one member or even three that deserve this honor. It's extremely hard. It's bittersweet. It's wonderful to give the award, but I feel so bad I can't put everyone's name on the plaque. But every year I'm able to come up with one or two names of people that I just really feel have shown the extra effort, leadership, positive attitude, which goes a long way when we work as hard as we do, that positive influence on their classmates. And so this year I've selected two people, and I'm going to ask you to wait until I've said both names, have them stand, and then give them their round of applause. Haley Klossman and Caitlin Hansen. Please stand. All right, we're on to Maelstrom. Again, this is one that we played at the Mass Band's concert, and again, it just gives us an opportunity to tweak those minor things that we've kind of been missing, and it makes working for that perfection possible. So, Maelstrom. Thank you. All right, as the percussion kind of settles into their spot, let's talk a little bit about Sweet Caroline. Over the years, there's kind of a director's philosophy when it comes to programming. And if it's you can come up with a tune that your audience can hum or whistle on their way out of the concert, you've done a good job. If you can come up with a piece that they will remember out the door. And so when the eighth grader suggested Sweet Caroline, I thought, yeah, that'll work great. That'll be a great closer. So we're going to play Sweet Caroline.
First, we'd like to thank you for being the best band teacher we ever had in middle school. And for putting up for us three in the back row.
Because you've been such an inspiration to us.
And here's Caitlin Hansen.
Mr. Tenault, we know it's tradition for the eighth graders to give you a gift every year. But every time we thought of something, we realized it had already been given to you. And since you are very special to all of us, we wanted to give you something that's worth remembering.
So now it's your turn to sit and listen to this song we got you. I hope you know how hard it is for a band to learn a song without the director. This one's for you.
Mrs. Goal, if you could come up and help us. And special thanks to Mrs. Goal, Miss Bright, and Mr. Gertz.
Thank you.
They don't tell you the real goal is to get me to cry. That's what the real goal is. Thank you, 8th grade, for a wonderful 3 years. Okay. And this is why I have the best job in the world.
Mr. Tettle, if you're wondering how we knew that was your favorite song, one day Caitlin and Ben, she was just sitting there, she's like, you know what? My favorite song is, wait, what's your favorite song? Well, she said some random song. And you're like, she asked you, what's your favorite song? And you said, Moonlight Sonata. So that's how we got it. Well, Wait. Okay, that wasn't planned. Okay, well, we just have to thank you for all the memories that we had, like the brown stand incident and a bunch of other stuff. Like, okay,
well, I got you something different. I got you some earplugs and some gum.
Thank you.
You're welcome. But honestly, I should be the one thanking you. I mean, over the years, you've been one of my favorite teachers and one of my favorite classes altogether, and you've been really inspirational to me. So, thank you.
Thank you.
One more thing. Just one. Oh, wait, one more hug. Okay. Every year, we always get him the Dr. Pepper. This year, we had a Gardetto's also, because that's his favorite snack. That machine ripped me off. I put $4 in, and I only got $3. It's a very stupid machine. Oh, now we got donuts. Well, we just want to thank you for all the memories that you gave us, and we're going to miss you.